30 seconds and counting. We've now found our internal power. 30 seconds and counting. 25 seconds and counting. We are still go. 20 seconds, guys.
Seems like we've been getting attacked at all again.
Again?
Again, but have no fear. We have the best shader coders to defend us, and especially Mothership Revision from being destroyed.
Good. And they come with the best DJs we have to offer as well.
Cause no war without a good soundtrack.
Exactly, so get ready for shader programming. Semi-finals! At
that's
this point.
Semi-finals!
The semi-finals!
So, just like yesterday, we will have two rounds, the semi-final, and afterwards we do a short break, about 10 minutes, and then we have the finals of the Shader Coding Showdown. So, we'll start with Musk versus Ibor. Please
get
come on
to
stage.
The stage. Are you ready?
Yeah.
Are you ready?
Yeah.
Musk is born ready.
Musk always comes prepared. All right. The next battle will be XT95 versus Kabuto. That's will start in about 30 minutes. So we start with Musk versus Ibor, and after that, in the end, we'll have the final round. The contestants have to be determined. So let's get the stink started.
Start countdown. 25 minutes. Music is provided by Alchema at this point, I think. Yep.
It sounds like Laguba, pretty much.
So, this is it, guys. The moment you should have trained for.
And again, we have Abducti and Chaos watching us from the back. If you have a question for Abducti about what's going on IRC, use the hashtag AskAbducti and he will try to answer them. And they will comment on the coding as well from a more technical perspective, as Moki and me are both idiots when it comes to programming.
That's true.
And a small correction, Oki, the hashtag is for Twitter, actually.
Oh, it's on Twitter. Cool. Where hashtags belong, so fair enough.
But you could also join the Revision IRC channel on IRCnet and ask questions there.
So yeah, we can see Musk, experienced Jada programmer at this point, defending last year's title. But then again, Ibor showed himself to be a worthy contestant yesterday, so it's going to be very exciting. And who will use the poo brain texture?
So we have a question from Micron on IRC. He asks, what hair gel product do the contestants use? I am not aware they use any hair product. Okay, so on first glance, it looks like most of our contestants today are adopting the strategy we saw from XT95 yesterday to do small, gradual changes of what you already have instead of writing a lot of code and hoping it will compile at the end of the day.
So, okay, I'm wondering, did you actually sneak the poo brain texture in there, or...?
I saw it just being used, so that's, I think that's a good thing, that's extra points. Anyone minutes on the clock.
And yes, Star Chaser and IRC spotted rightly that the guy on the right, which is Ibor, just deleted a bunch of the stuff that was already there. Was this a mistake? Well, we will see as this thing pans out. Oh, you guys just spawned a discussion on IRC whether the I++ or the +++I is the better way to increase integer. I stand with my current comment from yesterday. Let's rather talk about operating systems or religion.
Here we see a more compact form of a 2D rotation.
Oh yeah, on Ebor's side we see that he is, I think, trying to write a gradient function. We had that yesterday already. So he's definitely planning to do some ray marching or anything where a gradient function would help him.
Which means a lot more typing before we see more than a black screen.
yeah, it's an interesting strategy to like take some time at the beginning to write down a couple of useful functions that could come in handy later. But the question, as always, will be, can you make it in time? Let's see.
Oh, there's text poo brain in there.
It always helps while coding as an inspiration to have such kind of backdrop.
Yeah, I'm with you on that, Kyle.
In line 55, 56, we see this rotation thing. We had yesterday too, but this is a more compact form. Maybe it's easier to type or just fiddle around with.
First 7 minutes.
Okay, on every side there is an ever so slightly color gradient materializing, so maybe he's going somewhere. Let's see. So Harlech Revision asks, how many lines are there already in that editor before the compo starts? Well, feel free to check it out. It's done by Gargai and you can find it on GitHub.
It's basically just a tunnel, so it's nothing much. If at the end of the competition you just see a tunnel, then mostly nothing much was done.
Okay, what we see on music side is now a couple of nice chamfered cubes, and he's currently using the normal for coloring them, which is a technique, as we discussed yesterday, that is often used to visually debug all the pixels. But he is using them to color them here, I guess, so this makes also some nice colors if you like the colors.
Sometimes coder colors are actually for coding and not for looking at.
Well, coder colors are only for coding games. I hate to burst your bubble, but that's the way it is.
Also, both contestants have a fresh beer next to their monitor as well. If they want some refreshment, there's a beer.
So Abor looks like he's a bit in trouble. So if you guys want to see him succeed, maybe give him a hand and cheer a bit for Abor. Let's hear it for Abor.
Give it up.
Come on, guys. Give him a bit more. And is there a smile forming on Abor's face? No, I don't think so.
And again, rotation. That's a bad thing about live coding. There are so many functions which you usually have in a library, and now you have to type. And some of them are a little bit tricky, and so memorizing them, that would be just stupid, so you have to make it somehow.
I think the trick on that, Chaos, is actually to memorize how to build something fast out of the functions you already have in your given language, like HLSL or GLSL. Because it actually comes with a lot of stuff that is quite, can I say that on the stream, abusable?
Well, at least in HLSL there's no make quotation marks.
Do that.
So we have still 15 minutes left. 10 minutes past 15 minutes left.
So if you want to rotate something by three angles, you have to write these rod X and rod Y and rod Z, and then you have to multiply them. And it takes time.
Well, but my name has more char, or Sir Garbage Truck is actually asking something on Twitter. He says that last year Blueberry did something in 2D that ruled, but it was voted down. Well, we cannot do something about the votes. The votes are actually done by our nice audience, and they're clapping. And yeah, well, it's very subjective, so I'm sorry, Sir Garbage Truck, but you have to abide by what the crowd thinks. And for your next question, Sir Garbage Truck, if I think there is any place for a creative, non-ray marching entry in this contest, I would refer to my first answer. If you can please the crowd with what you're doing, I don't think it makes any difference if what you're doing is ray marching, a 2D effect, or maybe just some strobe effect. I don't know. If the crowd likes it, you can win with it. So yeah, that's the way it is.
On Eivor's side, I'll say, hello world.
So the question from Salinga from our IRC channel Hash Revision is whether Musics is actually going to make a Tetris. Well, at least he made one Tetris zone already. I don't see if he wants to do all of them. The code doesn't look like it at the moment, but maybe he's coming up with a Tetris that has only like this zone, but in a couple of different places. Using the repeat operators. So yeah, there could be a good chance he's heading for something like that.
We just passed the halfway mark, 12 and a half minutes.
Yeah, Constance remarking that some contestants look rather stressed and some look rather relaxed. I mean, that's a difference in personality, how you can handle to work under pressure and on the stage. I can say definitely for me, that would be like, no. I would never sit there and like in a room with a couple of thousand people and look at me while coding and see all my mistakes. That would make me crazy. On the other hand, with enough liquid courage, it might work. What do you think, Chaos? Would you do a thing like that?
I would suck at it.
Yeah, but I wasn't asking if you would be like good at it or not, but how would you feel about doing that?
It would work. You know, there are some people who go crazy if there's someone watching over their shoulder and they always have to turn their monitor so that nobody can look. I'm not that kind of person, so that would be okay. But I would suck at it, so I wouldn't do it because I don't like doing stuff I suck at.
Okay, you made your point.
So, next year's special battle, Abductee versus Chaos.
Well, that would be very one-sided. I never do Ray marching.
But fair point, and I'd say give it up for the contestants of our compo, because it takes balls to sit up here and be watched by so many people while you code. So give them a hand.
Okay, people on IRC starting to predict what the final will be. We are not taking bets at this point in time, because I think that gambling is still illegal, at least on the premise of Party Place. Or Defox, do you have a concession for that?
Hallo, hier spricht Defox. Im Saarland darf man nicht wetten.
And here we go. It's 10 minutes on the clock. 10 minutes.
Tom K on IRC said Rudeness saying he said this would be like the first sport he can enjoy watching. So give it up for Tom K. Okay, the question on IRC arose whether it is already drinking time or not. So if I look at both contestants, they both have like a bottle of beer next to their keyboard. I would say the answer is a pretty yes. Yeah.
They're both untouched though, untouched beers. I think they both of them haven't taken.
Oh, they didn't touch it. Okay. Maybe it's not the day to get day drunk, but it will be dark outside soonish, so then you can drink. Okay, Sunny on IRC says, did drinking time ever stop? Well, Sunny, that depends. Did you go to sleep?
It's always beer o'clock.
It's 8 minutes and we are looking at two more or less blank screens. So this is not over.
Okay. Oh. While Ivor is finally arrived at the spinning cube stage, there's some repetition going on music side.
Infinite spheres, always easy, always nice.
Okay, let's invert those spheres and we get like the cubey thing.
Infinite caverns.
Okay.
Death
or spheres.
That underground dance music.
Okay, more cubes. The race is on, guys. This is turning into something really fun.
That music that makes you reminisce.
And 6 minutes 30 seconds now.
It's about that music to make you feel good deep down inside. It's all about that music to when you wake up.
Okay, some line overlays coming into play here.
Last night,
for the audience again, the music comes via the FFT texture that gets uploaded, I guess, every frame. For details, please refer to the GitHub of Gargai, where you can find the source code to the same. But he's using it at the moment rather nicely as some line-ish overlays.
That's a good thing. Once you've got your basic ray marching ready, you can just get going. But getting there just takes some time.
Yes, Chaos, that's really the thing. Have your geometry and then just slap a repeat modifier on it, and then you're good to go.
We're getting close to the 5 minute mark.
Actually, I think this is the first time at this tournament where we had ray marching versus ray marching. Usually it was something advanced versus something artistic also.
You know, it's all about the music. That feel good music. That underground dance music. That music from back in the day. That music that makes you reminisce. It's about that music that makes you feel good deep down inside. It's all about that music that when you wake up, you say something like, Last night.
So we just got another question on IRC. It is from someone who is called Ogdirt, and he has an avatar pic that looks very much like Oki, and he's asking me what is my opinion on the Israel-Palestine issue. Well, actually, I think there is a nice song by Tim Minchin about eating pig's meat that would explain my... or rather the not eating of pig's meat, that would explain my position. And while I say that, oh my god, Abor is like really hitting the ground running. Yeah, look at that. There's like some repeat distance artifacts still in there, but the RNG...
That's not artifacts, that's stopped up cubes.
Yes, and the iteration glow is really, really coming in nicely. So let's look over to music. Okay, Musix is going a bit more psytrancey, so if you can add some nice rainbow colors on that, that would be nice.
Please don't.
Nevertheless, we are going straight for the last 3 minutes. Only 3 minutes left.
Okay, Chaos, just to clarify, I said rainbow, not RGB. There's a difference. If you don't know that, look it up, please.
Yeah. Not much. Also note, if this looks very dark now, it will look less dark once he switches off the editor. So, otherwise this would be a little bit too dark.
Okay, Chaos, would you be able to call this at this point? Do you have a favorite? Don't say who it is, but just say, would you be able to call this, or do you think they're still head-to-head?
This is still 2 minutes 30 seconds left, and given the fact how dark Musk's stuff is, I don't know what's going on there, you know? This is hard to call from this perspective.
Okay, so, guys, let's give Musix, Musk, I'm sorry, I get told it's pronounced Musk. Let's give Musk a hand and cheer a bit for him and also for Abor. This will be like fun last 2 minutes. Come on, guys, let's hear it.
Give it up!
So the decision for Abor would now be, do I fiddle with this and try to make it even better, or do I hope that the other one hasn't done anything better? So close to the end, I would think it's a decision you have to make to like risk it all and try something that might fail, or to go all in. Chaos, what would you do in this situation?
Don't ruin it.
Okay, so you would go for the conservative approach, I can see that.
You can always count on your opponent to ruin his.
Yeah, but that would be like a bit of like a poker game, right?
I don't play poker.
So, here we go. The last minute
is now starting. 1 minute on the clock, 1 minute. Programmers, give it everything you have.
The last 30 seconds, only 30 seconds left. So we are hitting for the last 10 seconds. Give it up for both contestants, Ibor and Mas. Give them a match. Cheer
10,
for them.
9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and full screen. So here we go. Give it up for Mas. Give it up for Ibor. What a battle.
And don't forget Alkama for the awesome soundtrack.
Let's take a look at both the effects and then we're gonna vote. Yeah, that's pretty good for 25 minutes, I'd say. So I think we're ready to vote. If you think Ibor on the left side of you with the rotating cubes, if you think Ibor should win, give it up for Ibor!
Ibor!
All right, but if you think Musk should win with this effect, give it up for Musk! Yeah, I think we have a winner. Musk, you go to the final to defend
Musk.
Your title. Well done, Ibor. Now give it up once more for Ibor for his effort on the screen and on the stage. And give it up for Musk. So, how are you feeling?
I wanted to make a different Tetris shape.
You want to make a different Tetris shape?
Next time. For the next one, no. I will do something different. That's too boring.
I hope so. Okay, so yeah, get down, chill out, get a beer, chill. And see you in the final. And thank you, Ibor. How was it going? You were struggling a little bit, it seemed.
I don't know what to say.
Oh, you did very well. I mean, once more, give it up for Ibor and his efforts. And now we're going to see who Musk is going to show down to in the finals. It's the second round, XT95 versus Kabuto. Get to the stage.
Bring your keyboards if you need a special one.
Bring your keyboards, your trackballs, your device, I don't know.
Your phasers.
Face.
Maybe your body as well.
So where is Kabuto sitting? On the left or on the right?
We have Kabuto on the right and XT95 on the left.
Du sitzt rechts, also Bühnenrechts. Wenn man drauf guckt, rechts. Ja. You need a French keyboard layout?
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, then machen wir das. Yeah, but you can. Yeah, so we already programmed the name, so it's better. Just attack the keyboard, check it with you. Yeah.
So for this round, the music will be supplied by Ronnie, who will bring the beats. So are we ready to start? Beam team, are we ready to start? Okay, I'd say let the coding commence.
Toby.
There we go, the countdown has started. The programmers can start.
So it's basically France versus Germany.
Ooh, that never happened before.
I'm very confident my fellow group member Kabuto is here, and I'm really certain he will drive this home for us. It will be really good. He will own France.
Well, we've seen XT95 busy yesterday. We know that they're both good programmers, so let's see what this will bring. It's a final semi-final. The winner of this will take on Musk for the 2015 revision title of Shader Coder of the Year.
Shaver Coder. The winner has to shave DeFox's head.
Also, contestants, there's a fresh beer next to your screen if you need refreshments.
So the first 2 minutes have already passed. Both are coding hard.
It's always the startup time that's a bit difficult. Not much is happening in the first 5 minutes. They have to set up their stuff.
Yeah, they're just setting up their subroutines for later use.
For later use. For revenge.
Here we see the beginning of some kind of marching around. But no function to march around.
It's the beginning
and
of a
Kabuto
marching
side,
band.
On side, we see the function to march around and just the beginning of some loop.
Because we all know that Germans like to march.
Oh yeah. We already saw the umlaut, so he's using a German keyboard.
Oh, okay. Welcome to the derailing shader coding compo.
Well, if he writes float fractal, you can assume what it's going to be, especially if you see the iteration loop in line 22 on XT side. And they are all typing and typing and typing. but you still only see, here we see
what it's going to be. Here we go, it's 4 minutes in and the first effects are being shown.
Caputo just enabled his loop.
And I don't know if it's just me, like Abukti and Chaos back me up, but it seems from what we have seen is that Caputo is very visual, tries to put stuff on the screen very quickly to work with, it seems.
Yes, Oki, you're right on that.
So, as last round, please ask your questions on Twitter, hashtag AskAdapti or on IRC.
And we found out that he will answer every question, so feel free to ask him anything. But preferably make it about the shader coding competition.
So, sorry guys that I'm a bit late to the party. I had to greet my nice friends from LNX, so shout out to them. IRC is pretty quiet at the moment and nobody's asking something on Twitter. So I will just go with stating the obvious, that obviously both guys are doing like the XT95 sort of strategy, which is gradually modifying what is already there instead of like writing a bunch of code and getting it to compile, which doesn't seem to be a good strategy in this high pressure situation. And yeah, and Caputo seems to be a bit ahead right now. What do you think, Chaos?
Yeah, as I said, he just enabled his loop, and now we see what he's going. The tunnel is just on top of it. It'll go away sooner or later, or maybe used for some extra effect in some way.
Yes, and I think Caputo is now like using the display the normals as colors trick. I don't know if he's doing this for debug purposes or if he actually is shooting for getting some effect out of it, but although it's only like a red and a green right now, it looks kind of rather nice, so yeah, that's good.
It's a very advanced color scheme, absolutely. On XT side, we still don't really see what his code will look like. We can only guess from the code. I mean, it's called Fractal, it looks like the Fractal. What should it be? But it's not enabled, obviously.
Well, Chaos, I have to disagree with you on that. It looks like a normal Perlin noise, but you could argue that the Perlin noise also is a fractal, because if you write it in a certain way, you can zoom into it endlessly. I mean, at least until your float range clips or something, so. Oh, and Caputo just broke his thing, but I think he will get it back to the early. So, on IRC, what is currently going on? People are remarking that the term of the use shader was publicly introduced by Pixar in their Random and Interface specification and originated in the year 1988, so there's a bit of history for you. And also, people are referring to IQ's examples and the shader toy tutorials and so on. Actually, I don't know if you guys seen the really, really, really nice lecture of my good friend and colleague Coupe on the NVC about modeling stuff with sine distance functions. And he promised there that he's about to release the loop that actually helped us to create the great visuals in the timeless. So look out for that. Look out for the murky_labs on Twitter. We will announce this as soon as it happens. And if I understood Cooper correctly, it will happen. So look out for that.
About that history, I totally don't like the word shader because it can mean anything. So it's just confusing to talk about shaders. This code has a part in it that does the shading. Actually, it doesn't yet, but we'll come to that, I suppose. But most of the code doesn't shade anything.
Yeah,
Now we start to see the first things. I say, indeed, people, give it up for Kabuto. Give it up for XT95. Coding their asses off on stage for you. 16 and a half minutes left on the clock.
On XT's side, on the first glance, it looks, oh my god, there's nothing. But if you look closely, you see it's just too dark. In the border, you see there's actually something really interesting going on. It's just
too
dark for us to see it because the editor is on. And here you see he just gave us a glimpse of what's going to come. This is a lot more than it looks like.
Indeed.
It's just hidden by the tunnel that's still running on top of it.
Is he hiding his secret effect to unveil
no,
it?
No, it's not hiding. It's just the way the software works.
Oh, that's less enticing than this.
Unfortunately, I wish here at the organizer, at the Beam team, we could press a button and see it in all glory, but that would fuck them up too much.
Yeah, let's not mess with them too much. They're busy enough as it is. Kabuto going all colorful.
Well, I don't see all colors.
Nah, he's not Dutch. Hopefully he will leave some alone.
So we are approaching the 15 minute to go mark, and this is shaping up to be like a really, really good battle between XT95 and Kabuto. Both contestants are still with like obviously a lot of time left, and all good things are still to come. So stay tuned and watch this. This is really, really fun. While on IRC, people are now more talking about how the word shader came to be, which is also interesting. But guys, look at the big screen. Look up once in a while. There's the real life. There's the big screen. There are two people cutting it out and like having it at each other on an intellectual level while writing shaders. So don't look up stuff on Wikipedia, guys. Look at this. This is exciting. Let's hear it for both contestants. Give them a hand. Come on, cheer them on.
Now cheer them on and make some noise if you're enjoying this battle. The closest the demo scene will ever get to a rap battle, I think.
Oh yeah, you've seen the movie 8 Mile, okay, haven't you?
Minutes and both have the basics down. Now the tweaking and the making nice part.
Oh, okay, you did something. The closest the demo scene will ever get to rap battle command is now really, really, really appreciated by the guy on the IRC channel, hashtag revision. You did something there.
It would be awesome if they actually put like the disses in comments. Like, I'm gonna do something with this texture, bitch.
Yeah.
And Ronnie laying down the Ghostbusters. Give it up for Ronnie supplying us with some fresh beats for them to go to.
Happy Halloween.
We can really see what XT is up to. And it's really atmospheric. And obviously, Kabuto is not going for atmospheric.
So we're going for the half-time mark. So 12 minutes, 30 seconds gone, 12 minutes, 30 seconds left.
There's still plenty of time to completely mess this up and get it back running. So I'm really, let's see what's coming.
Oh yeah, Kabuto's like really hitting the sweet spot now. If you ever took
chemical drug somewhere in your life, you would really appreciate what Kabuto is doing right now.
Chemical drugs?
Which I have only heard of from friends.
Which we as Revision don't condone.
Be Most careful, be chemical. Safe, dare, be smart. Use drugs responsibly.
Yeah, binge responsibly.
Most players are drinking very responsible.
If you're watching the stream, Mom, I'm not doing drugs.
Yeah, tell that to the police officer, Aki. Just have your story straight, right?
Oh, snap.
So we see things happening. We're getting closer and closer to the 10-minute mark. It's 11:26 at this point. So, Abductee Chaos, do you guys see something evolve from this that we are not seeing on the screen yet?
Yeah, well, obviously Kabuto is like really going into layering a lot of psychedelic stuff. He's using couple of nice tricks to get the color to shift the way he wants to. Especially since he's getting some, you know, when you put your eyes a bit together and look straightly into the sun and you sort of squint your eyes, he's getting a bit of this effect in the background of his tunnel, which is really, really nice. He should do something about the foreground colors though, but I think he's well on that. As for XT95, Chaos, if you could go over to XT95 right now. He seems to be struggling a bit with getting what he wants to do to compile. So, but there's like still well over 10 minutes left. So let's see what he comes up with. So I couldn't call this at the moment. Chaos, could you?
Well, no, with 10 minutes to go and plenty of time. But obviously, XT is trying to. This is something like water, but very boring water, so he has to change how the water moves. And that's what he's just editing, making more interesting movements. He's got the atmosphere, but, well, he's improving the movements.
Okay.
So yeah, the last 10 minutes have just started. It's 10 minutes left, 15 minutes we had. There's already some interesting stuff on the screen.
So Anti is remarking on IRC that people who are mixing Core and OpenGL 4.3, so stuff like GLBegin and the fixed function pipeline with 4.3 shaders, those people should be shot. I don't think that's a law in Germany at this point in time, and also that's what compatibility modes are for. And while I say that, I think XT95 just got something to work, and that looks like he has some sort of sky there. And although it's a bit noisy at the moment, it looks like a sea or an ocean. So what do you think about that, Chaos?
Yeah, as I said, atmospheric movements built off, but that's tweaked right away. Obviously the colors must be adapted to.
So guys, this deserves a hand. XT95 is the first guy I've seen in this competition to like really write code for a long time and spend his time and getting it compiled at the end to make this strategy work. So let's hear it for XT95. Come on, cheer him on. That was good.
Thank you.
with a kind of weird thing Kabuto is doing, it's really hard to tell how this will look in 5 or 7 minutes. And it's only 7 minutes and 30 seconds left. So we can only wait and see how this evolves.
And it's quite awesome that in even that short amount of time, so much can still happen.
So IRC is remarking that Kabuto went full LSD now. I cannot like discourage people from thinking that. Yeah, he's really doing some nice stuff with the colors. Yes. Okay, so a person called Bob Fungus, which I don't know who that is, asked me something on Twitter, which is a more general question. Do you see an easy way out of the coder colors compos have offered? Well, the twofold answer. First of all, I hope you have seen the color grading seminar by Mercury's Psycon. If not, there should be a video of it later. So he shows you some easy tricks how to get out of it. And second of all, look at Shader Toy, look around. There are some really, really easy functions that use like sine and cosine to give you out of a normal vector or out of a depth, out of a distance. Really good colors, and you can also just think about mapping colors to other colors. So,
sorry, real quick interruption. It's
really
less than 5 minutes.
I'm sorry, Aki, what you were saying?
Sorry to interrupt you, but it's the 5 minute mark just passed. We have 4.5 minutes on the clock now. They really have to step up their game. They really have to get ready to bring it. They really have to get down in the ring.
Sorry, I got a bit like wrestling on you.
So Chaos, again, the same question. What would you do now? Like, go all in for it, or hope the other guy makes a mistake and just polish the thing you have and not risk anything?
Yeah, that's a good question indeed. Like, would you risk it if you have something that looks already kind of good? The less minutes you have, the more dangerous it gets.
Yeah, but there's still four minutes. Oh, my voice.
We can see their faces. Kabuto is very in it. He's typing. And XD95 looks a bit more worried, he's a bit more...
Well, XD95 stuff is supposed to look nice, and that's very easy to mess up. While Kabuto's stuff is pretty kaput ready, so whatever.
But Kabuto's a style that's actually good for at least German people.
Yes, of course, but you know, a wrong color wouldn't ruin Kabuto's entry. While a wrong color could ruin XC95's entry.
Oh, this is getting very interesting up in here. We're 3.5 minutes on the clock.
And also this black thing, I think that's not intentional. it's also always problematic with the music sync. So if the music sync is too fiddly and the music changes, then everything looks different and that's just awful.
We're 3 minutes on the clock, but would you say, would that throw people off? Is it actually more difficult with the music changing than it would be without?
The music has to change because it's live. Everything else would be boring.
No, but I mean,
it depends on how much does your shader depend on the music. That's the question.
Chaos, the answer to that is really, really easy. You could just put in like a dummy function that gives you just like a sine wave instead of the FFT to like do a check that you can toggle on and off. So
yes,
I would probably go
but
for something
like that.
But that
would be discouraged by the audience, I suppose.
Yeah, okay. But Chaos, answer me one more question. What would be for you the point where you would stop risking things? You have like 25 minutes and at the beginning you have to make like big steps, but where would be the cutoff point for you to make like not any risk taking anymore?
I think we should ask the contestants because they already done it at least once, if not Kabuto has some experience. How should I know? I've never done this. Ask the ones.
Okay, maybe Oki can ask them afterwards, but I wanted to hear your opinion. But having said that, it's like we're down to 1 minute and 45. And this is shaping up to be really, 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 really close battle.
Absolutely. XT has it all. He has the blue, he has the red, he has the green.
The red, the green.
And only 90 seconds to go. 90 seconds left on the clock.
Okay, we're approaching the last minute and it is really, really too close to call. I couldn't decide on a favorite. Oh my god. I think Kabuto just put in some blur thingy that looked really nice. On the other hand, XT95 is also coming around really good. Oh, he has a new thing that syncs more to the music. So both of the guys are really, really, really giving it their all to come up with something good in the last minute. The last minute has approached, guys. Last minute. Guys, cheer them on. Come on, give them a hand.
Give them a hand. They only have 50 seconds left.
And we are hitting the 30-second mark. Only half a minute left, so do you want to really risk anything at that point?
Yeah, now it comes down to it. It's 20 seconds. They really have to finish up what they're doing and prepare to show it to us. 15 seconds. Let's give them a countdown at 10, 9,
8,
7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1,
full screen!
Give it up for Kabuto and XT95! Here we have XT95's effect, give it up! And Kabuto's effect.
Give it up for Kabuto!
So let them work on you for a little bit and then we're gonna vote. Two very, very worthy contestants. So yeah, if you enjoyed XT95, show XT95's effect. If you enjoyed this effect, give it up for XT95! You wanted to win!
So,
but if you want Kabuto to win, show Kabuto's effect. Give it up for Kabuto!
Give it up for Kabuto!
Oh, this is really hard to call.
That's a close call.
This is really hard to call. I think we have to do it again. Again, XT95. Give it up for XT95. Give it up for Kabuto! No, I think XT95. I think it's does the jury all of a sudden. Chaos and Abductee agree with me. Hands, oh yeah, hands, fair enough. XT95, hands up.
Up, all of them. Also in the back, all of them. Right, Kabuto, hands up.
Yes, for Kabuto.
God damn, it's still really close. It's
yeah, that's really hard to decide.
Actually, we go into extra time. 5 more minutes. No, we don't actually. We don't actually, because we don't have time for them. Sorry. I have no idea what to do. A fist fight.
Okay. You could change the music and see which ones react better.
Change the music. Okay. Are we changing the music and see which one works better? So we're going to Luguber and bass? Is it feeding in? Okay, yeah, I think we're gonna have to do one more cheer off. Cheer off and hands. Let's just see if that works. For XT95, cheer and hands!
And for Kabuto! It's so hard to decide.
I'm not gonna say anything. Okay, shall we? Can we do overtime? Or is that really mean? Can we give him 5 more minutes?
So
I don't know who I'm asking this to, but is that, shall we give him 5 more minutes? Okay, I'm gonna time it. Are you guys ready to do 5 more minutes? I'm gonna time it. Guys have 5 more minutes to work on your effects.
Okay, Chaos is doing the 5 minute timing.
Okay,
just hold on for a second.
I don't know if it's enough, but I mean we're gonna give you some overtime because it's really hard to call. They both look really uncomfortable right now.
Yeah, that's a problem when you're too good.
I think it's a problem. Like 5 minutes is nothing.
So I'm hearing we're going to do the 25 timer. But we are going to use it only to 20.
Okay, so this is what we're going to try because it's so close to goal. You guys are going to get 5 extra more minutes. 5 extra more minutes to make something. I don't know if it will help, but it's so close. Let's see what you guys can do in 5 minutes. Overtime. We go to overtime.
Let's give
it up for XT95 and Kabuto.
5 minutes.
Overtime has started. You have 5 more minutes to tinker with your effect. Within seconds, they've copied each other's effects somehow.
Okay, 4 minutes, 30 seconds.
Okay, so this is the first at the Shader Showdown. We are going to overtime. And the question now really is, oh my god, what can I do? I mean, if you practice this beforehand, you maybe have timed it to the whole 25 minutes, and if you still have something left that you couldn't do on stage, maybe the 5 minutes help you. Maybe you practice enough and you got all your things done in 25 minutes and now you're a bit of lost. I don't know.
XT definitely has a couple of bugs in his code, and I'm sure it will look a lot better if he just fixes it. On the other side, Kabuto's stuff is already really weird. Adding more weirdness wouldn't make it necessarily better.
So if you were Kabuto, Chaos, would you forfeit the 5 minutes and just say, I wouldn't do nothing and it's perfect already? It's the best
no.
I can do?
Well, I wouldn't have done this. My colors are bad, but they're not that bad.
Okay, I hear you.
So I get a question from IRC if there is a way to use the music without it having a sort of a Winamp feeling to it. Well, actually, that what you describe as a Winamp feeling is called fast Fourier transformation. and basically everybody's using that, so maybe something else can be used, but FFT is what everybody is sort of used to, so I don't think it would be fair, or you have to give it out to people in advance. On the other hand, looking
2 minutes 45, look at this, I think XT95 is going to take a risk.
Yeah, okay, XT95 seems to be a risk taker, while Kabuto, okay, there's some new stuff appearing.
Two and a half minutes already, we see like quite some change in this.
Okay, I see lines appearing.
Everyone sees lines appearing.
Yeah, but I think it's like parts of a sine wave, not the actual lines.
It's really quite impressive what they can achieve in only 5 extra minutes. Give it up for our contestants. What a battle.
And okay, with 2 minutes left.
2 minutes.
XT95 is going to be more doing stuff with the music, with the FFT of the music.
Yo, you have a license to play this? Oh, my operator not have a license, man. If you get a license to play them kind of dope later, you know. What's he want to get up? Sure. I tell you, you're dangerous enough.
Here's the signs.
We have the dance under full control.
So 1.5 minutes for probably the most intense shader battle we've ever seen at Revision.
Okay, I hear there will be an important announcement after this about German parking rules, so stay tuned for that as well.
So here we are. 2, 1. 1 minute left at this point. 1 minute left. So this is the last minute you get to work on this.
And it's important that the music continues rolling once the coders are finished, so that the code can still react to the music.
Stop. 40 seconds coming up.
Okay, guys, cheer them on.
Cheer them on.
35 seconds.
30 seconds.
Cheer them on for the last half minute.
And after that, you guys that are cheering now have to decide which one is better.
These guys have been going.
Cheer!
Come on, these guys have been coding for 25 minutes, and then 5 minutes they didn't even know about. The last 15 seconds coming up.
Whoa.
Yeah, we're there to the 10-second countdown. 10,
9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, full screen!
Okay, so here we are with 5 minutes extra time. People, now it comes down to it. Let's quickly look at the effects before we vote. XT95's effect, here you go. Managed quite some change in 5 minutes. Kabuto's effect.
Yo! That's for 5 minutes.
And now it comes down to it. I want to see hands and cheers. Hands and cheers if you want XT95 to win. Hands and cheers.
And for Kabuto, hands and cheers.
Well, I think we have a winner then. Kabuto.
That made it a little bit easier. So, I'd say the winner of the semifinals and therefore participating in the final round of the Shader Countdown is Kabuto!
Give it up! But also give it up for XT95 for being damn good competition and for a damn good battle. So very quickly, Kabuto, how are you feeling?
Slightly exhausted.
And XT95, very well done. How do you feel?
Good.
Yeah, give it up once more for Kabuto in 1995. What a show. So now we're going to have a short break before the final, because else Kabuto will die. So 15-minute break, I think, and then we have the final.
Musk versus Kabuto.
And to show you guys we're for real, we have the statues right here, first and second place. I'll put them near the DJs.
But there's no first and second place for the DJs.
All our DJs are number one to me.
Oh, the import taxes would be hilarious,
too. LeGuber stole the second prize as well.
fair enough.
Fair enough. So here they are, second place, first place. This is what it's about.
Bob, please report to the info desk. Something is strange with your old school recording. Bob, please report to the info desk. Important, if your car is not parked in a marked parking place, please check the second screen whether you're blocking an emergency exit and remove your car. I repeat, if your car is not parked in a marked parking space, please check the second screen whether you are blocking an emergency exit and remove your car immediately. Thank you.
3, 4.
Ignoriert mich gerade einfach bitte, ich muss ja bestimmt was einstellen. Ich brauche dafür das Mikro. Check, 1, 2. Hey, 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 1, 2. So, danke. Looking. Hey. 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 One, two. Hey. Hey. No. Eins, zwei. Hey. Drei, vier. Fünf, sechs, sieben, acht. Neun, zehn. Elf. 12. 2 Hey One, two. Hey. 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 Eins. Hey. Hey. Hey.
Till.
Hey, hey, again, we have a few cars that are parked wrong and they're blocking the fire escape lane. So please watch the screen if you're on the screen. Or if you have one of those cars, like German WLAW646, BIROM30, KVC64, HHB7478, SBAS178, FC2396 or SBJK933, or if you're French and have a car, CA018CR, or if you come from Luxembourg and have the license plate with the number 230097, or if you have a yellow license plate that reads 82SGNS, please park your car somewhere else because otherwise we need to tow them. Sorry. Okay, turns out a few of those cars were actually organizers. Blue Tooth of TMP, please come to the info desk. somebody from Ghost Town at the info desk. Anybody from Ghost Town, please come to the info desk right now. Thank you.
So, Musk and Kabuto, Musk and Kabuto, please come to the main stage. Beam Team, wir können.
So yes, it's time for the Shader Coding final.
It's going down.
After a gruesome battle, give it up for our two finalists, Musk and Kabuto.
Give it up!
Give it up! So get on the stage, get ready. So, Musk, you sit here, Kabuto on the other side.
The places you already know.
On the turntable are spinning the two awards that we're going to give out after this. Second place, first place, share the coding. Thank you, Lugubre. Look at them. They're pretty. They're very pretty. This is about something, people. And were you people enjoyed by this battle so far? Were you? Give it up. Excellent. So I think, are we ready?
I'm ready. Are you ready? Kabuto?
They're ready. The clock is on. Give it up. Musk versus Kabuto, the final Revision 2015 Shader Coding Contest battle, final, battle, final.
Final.
And start. And here we go. The time is running, the first 25 minutes.
Lights out and away we go. This is it, guys. The moment you should have trained for.
And we see Kabuto only had a 15-minute break, so he had some time to freshen up. Musk had some more time to prepare and think about his strategies. They both have a fresh beer. Don't worry. Here we have Musk on the screen. As Gargai called him, the Iceman. Cold as ice. So I went on an investigation. The Goober called him the Iceman. The Goober called him the Iceman. The Goober, who also himself is an Iceman, and who is also supplying the music for this battle. It's the Goober on the decks. So again, the first few minutes, people setting up, people getting ready. And as Musk is defending the title, Musk won last year. Musk has done this quite a few times now. He's a seasoned veteran of the Shader Coding competition. Well, Kabuto was participating last year as well. So they both started at the bottom and now they're here.
Okay, Chaos is pointing out to me that people are using different spellings of the word color. Chaos, this is really not the time and place to diss people about their spelling, really. Come on, this is finals. Come on, guys, let's hear it. It's finals!
Yes, exactly, the final round!
And we see two people on top of their game, and it's early days still, but they both seem to have learned from XT95 from the qualifying yesterday that it's a good strategy to do some incremental changes, because what they're doing at the moment, both as far as I can see, is they're doing incremental changes. They are not going for risking it all and doing the big blocks. I just got informed by Cyrex that my plug is too big and doesn't fit anywhere. I don't know what to make of this.
So the batteries for the Twitter are running out. They're down to 8.6%.
Ah, okay, that's what it's about. I thought something different, sorry. And once upon a time, I found myself in some
circumstances held on by some spiritual vampires. I will say,
things in the microphone by accident.
Okay, on a different note, all the guys who have been shown on the screen with their cars and even the Orgas, please move your cars now. You're blocking a safety way. It's not good, guys. Good.
The first 4 minutes have already passed, but 21 minutes to go.
Again, the code, Kabuto's coding. Ah, code must actually do something. Okay.
Okay, well, we are approaching the final 20 minutes. The Move Your Car from the Safety Way competition is going on outside. So guys, move your car. This is a service announcement. Okay, Chaos, what do you say? I think they're still evenly matched and it has all the time to go and they're still putting stuff in and not compiling too often. We can really make heads or tails of it right now, can we?
They're laying out their stuff. They're not really seeing what they're working on. We can only look at the code again. There's this iteration loop, so it's going to be something fancy, hopefully. But unless you see what's going to be iterated, that's hard to tell. Here we're getting some something.
And again, oh. Kabuto already showing stuff on the screen.
Yeah, Kabuto seems to be going for the incremental changes and layering stuff upon stuff kind of approach. While Musk is... Can you go over to Musk, please, again, Kevin? Thank you. While Musk is trying to put stuff in, and there's some lines appearing, so... what do you make of it?
Well, this is going to be 3D because we see the 3D rotations coming up. All three angles, X, Y, and Z.
Okay, so there's a cube forming. So guys, we have our first cube. Give it a hand.
We've got the cube.
A cube!
Here you go, 19 minutes, 10 seconds. We have a rotating cube on the screen. Oh, back in the day, it would take months to make a cube.
Okay, from the crowd response, I gather you're not that excited about cubes anymore.
But it always starts with a cube. The cube is the hello world of 3D graphics. Not the teapot, it's a cube.
And I think the crowd already also expects quite a lot from these guys. These guys have proven themselves already to know their stuff. So we're not that easily impressed anymore by what they do.
Yeah, so what I am really interested in is Kabuto last time did the incremental change of what we already have. So now that he's presented with the same starting point, is he going to go down the same road and will it look like anything he did in the semifinals? Or can he manage to go in a different direction and start out from the same thing and produce something else that is really cool and like really captures the imagination of the crowd? While we are looking over at Musk, and we see still the cube. So let's see where he goes with the cube. We've seen in the qualification and the pre-finals some amazing stuff that was built out of cubes. So let's not count anyone out. There's like still 17 minutes and 52 seconds to go.
So just as a small reminder, there's still the possibilities you can tweet to hashtag AskAdacti or just use RC if you have any questions to or about the Shader Cup of Finals. Please use that and Adacti will answer all the questions.
It seems Musk is doing something quite interesting at this point.
Yes, he rotated the cube a couple of times and now it's going to a little bit Mad Wizard with this. Also, obviously, there's lots of artifacts.
Yeah, okay, so Musk is using a spherical repeat to make some cool shapes out of a cube. Let's see where he goes with that.
That's the thing, if you have the cube down, you can do anything.
And see what he's doing. Yeah, well, we're still looking into like are we at warp speed, Chaos? Would you say we are at warp speed?
Definitely not. I mean,
okay.
Just look how it's moving. I could walk that fast.
Yes, please do. But later.
Depending on scale, obviously.
Okay.
But this is far from done. But I can realize the traditional Kabuto Kalashins going to deep saturation.
Yeah, well, what Kabuto does always looks like a bit of something you would expect, like from a Japanese music video, maybe, because it's very colorful. But still, he seems to make these colors that look a bit like a CGA palette. But he still seems to get them working in the composition.
Also, if your colors are that extreme, you can't really fuck them up. They are already fucked up, and it's not subtle, but it works.
Yeah, well, so I think this is really, really, really in the eye of the beholder, or the eye of our crowd in this kind of instance.
I meant it in a technical way. If you are trying to create a mood with well-chosen colors, you can fuck it up easily. If you're trying to go for harsh colors, I mean, this can't be fucked up by a little error. It's already...
Okay, I see where you're going with this.
So it's fucked up in a good way, and you can't really make it much worse.
Okay, yeah, but I think another point that we should stress is if you want to do this competition maybe next year, what we've seen here is that it doesn't really have to be, if you're up there and writing your code, it doesn't really have to be that exact and that precise, and you don't have to like implement, like for example, say a physically based shading or something that is correct. All you have to do is something that is reasonably good, or as I say, good enough, and that is pleasing the crowd. So there's a lot of a performance aspect in here more than a coding or a physically correct or a mathematically correct aspect. Would you agree?
Yes, I think XC95 went for something more subtle, something more beautiful, but there wasn't the time to really pull it off, and then he had to fuck it up, and that didn't work.
Yeah, well, I'm very happy that we did not have to decide like the semi-final, because
it would
have been really hard, because the Kabuto one was more pleasing on an aesthetic kind of way, while the XT95 one was technically more brilliant. So I wouldn't really have known what to choose.
XT95's look unfinished. Kabuto stuff cannot look unfinished, because it never will.
Okay, so you're saying this is kind of a strategy to do something that will look a bit
strategy.
Raw?
Not necessarily a strategy, more like the way you want to go.
Okay, while Musk is having some kind of pencil, let's look over to Kabuto, what he
could be a
to.
Crystal. If you multiply it a lot, it could be a crystal. Sync. On Kabuto's side, we have some sync. That's very hard with the changing music.
So yeah, we've been already going out. It's 13 minutes, 20 seconds at this point. It's a very tense vibe here on the stage. We need a nickname for Kabuto as well. We have the Iceman.
Musk is the Iceman, because you can't tell
Star
what
Chaser
he's thinking.
Is sort of asking if Musk is trying to create the revision rocket. That would be awesome if he could get this done.
Oh
so
dear.
Let's see how it shapes out. And Kabuto seems to be sticking to what he knows, and he is about to try to make it work, I guess. Okay, but there's like a new element, some kind of fog coming in. What do you make of this, Chaos?
Halfway point, 12 and a half minutes.
Oh.
We're at the halfway point. Oh. Here you go, give it up, people. Give it up for Kabuto, give it up for Musk. Give it up for our Shader Coder finalists. And both taking really different approaches. Or at least in my newbie eyes. I don't know.
Well, it's visual art, so trusting your eyes, not the worst idea.
Thank you, thank you.
Truck asks that he's wondering how much time Musk is spending during the year doing this. Well, I mean, I have to speak for myself. Once you start doing stuff with distance functions, it gets really, 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 really addictive in a really short amount of time. So if you want to try it, do it. But if you are like a person that succumbs to addictive things very, very easily, be careful with what you're starting.
Whoa. As we pass through the hallway.
Yeah, give it up. You're allowed to cheer, people. You're allowed to cheer for these guys. So we just decided when we have Musk as the Iceman, Kabuto is the German Treff. Look at him. Look at him go.
Why are Germans always German?
I don't know, we are just Germans.
It's the easy way out.
You guys, you
don't make me do this! More.
So Kabuto seems to be onto something. No, you so you're allowed to cheer, so if you like what you're seeing, cheer.
Kabuto really is building something. Left.
Yes, 10 minutes, people, and we're seeing quite interesting stuff happening. Not really. Is it me, or is it like, do we expect more, or we're like, is this booming? From a technical perspective, Chaos Abductee, is this already quite impressive?
Yes, I think everything you do in 15 minutes or less, or just above as we are now, is impressive. That is visually pleasing. I sometimes struggle for days to get something to look visually pleasing. So, I think it is.
Fair enough, yeah. So people, once more, please give it up for our contestants, because this is really awesome. Oh my god, everything broke.
Wrong button. Oh. Sorry.
Yo, dog.
Ta-da.
Here we go. 9 minutes
okay,
coming
up. Okay, for Solo, who fixed our technical problem in the nick of time.
Thank you, Solo. Nine minutes, people. This is the last 10 minutes. You're only mere seconds away from victory. There's going to be a winner. There's going to be a loser.
Maybe Musk was a bit overambitious with it.
Oh my god, there's
only
lights everywhere!
Only 8 minutes and 40 seconds left to turn this into more than a projectile. Also, colors, backgrounds, awesomeness, not yet here. Maybe plan B or something. On Kabuto's side, we are well in the awesomeness area. At least for something that took less than 20 minutes to create from scratch.
So Yogi is asking a very interesting question on IRC. He was wondering if the shaders from last year's contestants and also this year's contestants are and will be released at some point in time. I would say this is a question we should take seriously, and we should really, really, really do this. So
yeah, we have all the shaders saved from all the contestants.
Yeah.
All of it is saved. All of it will be released, I guess, somehow at one point. So you can look at all the shaders created in this competition after the party.
Okay, I nominate you to take care of this.
Yes, no problem. I looked at Gargoy and Gargoy went, yes. So, all good. 7.5 minutes coming up. 7.5 minutes, people. That's the length of one terrible Animal Collective song.
Now we've got the background for Musk. This is now something, not just the projector. We see
I'm now wondering, is Musk making a rocket?
Obviously, yes.
Yeah.
Because I'm an idiot.
It's flying on a moon, over a moon.
You can't see a moon if it's right next to you.
Maybe he is doing a shader pig. Shader pig, shader pig.
Does whatever.
Could be a rocket, could be a pig.
Oh, Kabuto is going all Knight Ridery flashy on us. Yes, give it up, give it up, people. Give it up if you enjoy what you're seeing.
7 minutes left, less than.
Okay, so there are like wild conspiracy theories on IRC right now that Musk is making a rocket that he's launching over to Kabuto to destroy his team.
Also important, when you do this, you start with a tunnel. Never delete the tunnel. You never know if you need a tunnel in the last 5 minutes.
Yes, and never make any brown bump mapping. Okay, guys on IRC, could you not talk about like painkillers right now and watch at the screen and see this impossible cool competition? Thank you.
We're going for the color scheme of the rocket here, but I doubt we will see any fins for the rocket.
Okay, a shader pick has appeared on IRC.
I think I see what Musk is doing, though.
Oh.
5.5 minutes, 5.5 minutes, people.
I think both approaches are so awesome.
Okay, I think we all see at this point where Musk is heading, and let's hope he can put it off. Let's cheer on for a bit. Come on. Cheer for Musk now.
Cheer
He's
for
trying
Musk.
To do the rocket, obviously.
He's really have to bring it. 5 minutes, 10 seconds left.
Yeah, here
this
we
can
go.
Work.
We're hitting.
But on Kabuto's side, we are getting along.
And here we are, 5 minute mark. 5 minutes, the last 5 minutes. The last 5 minutes of the Revision 2015 Shader Battle. People, please give it up for our coders. I know you've been clapping a lot, but this is pretty awesome.
So Chaos, what do you think? Is it possible to add the fins in the last 5 minutes to the rocket?
The fins?
Or the hail
maybe,
rods?
Maybe the fins are already done in his head, but maybe they're just not working. We'll see. I don't think so. I don't think it will reverse the time spent in the last minutes doing fins. I mean, the bendy, planety stuff, that's much more exciting than fins ever will be. But a smoke train, that will be huge.
Okay, I hear you. But I still wonder who Shader Pig on IRC is.
But on Kabuto's side, with the early awesomeness, there's little progression here.
4 minutes.
So, Abdaki, is Kabuto preparing something code-wise? There's no progression in the visuals right now, but maybe here's something that he's hiding from us.
Since Chaos keeps like, skipping the screen all the time, I didn't really pay attention, I'm sorry. he might as well have. So, let's assume he has.
3.5 minutes.
But I think the shader pick could be like a real, real good trophy that we could introduce like next year. What do you think about the trophy? Should be a shader pick next year? Let's hear it, crowd. Anyone? Okay, one guy was whistling, so it will be
one guy got the joke.
Yes, thank you. Thank you, Brian.
3 minutes. Yeah, here we go. We're going into the last few minutes of the competition. It's a very, very different looking things happening on the screen.
Okay, guys, so the big question is, can Musk keep it together and add some pins? And has Kabuto something in his backhand, something up his sleeve that he will put on at the last couple of minutes? We will see. This is exciting stuff.
It is, and we're getting very close to the 2 minute mark. It's 2 minute 20 at this point. Programmers, 2 minutes, 20 seconds. And here we are, we're gonna hit the 2 minute mark, the last final 2 minutes of this competition. 2 minutes. And the final minute and a half, will they have time to make something extra out of their scene? They only have a minute and a half left.
Come on, guys, 1:30 left. Cheer them on. Cheer.
Cheer them out.
Okay, and as we see, Kabuto have something in his backhand that he just unleashed upon us.
Kabuto, sure, to the end, working. Waiting to the end. And now it's a minute, nearly a minute, and he is changing the scene. And here we are, 1 minute left. The last 60 seconds have gone in. You guys have 60 seconds to wrap up.
Okay, this is where the rubber meets the road. This is where it gets exciting. So Musk is still working on his one. I don't see what he's doing right now. I think he's trying to add the tail fins. Let's see if we can do it in 37 seconds. And if we go over to Kabuto, we see
30 seconds.
There's some new stuff coming in. Okay, this is good. This is nice.
This is the last 30 seconds. Kabuto opening every register he has, literally. 20 seconds. Yeah, we're gonna go down to the final 10 people. Clap at me, cheer at me for the last 10 seconds. 10,
9. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, full screen!
Here we go, let's take a look at the effects. Let's start with Musk. Musk's effects, look at it. And let's take a look at Kabuto's effects.
Let's see Kabuto.
Give it up for Kabuto!
Okay, now it comes down to you, people. It comes down to you to decide who's gonna win the first place trophy and the second place trophy. So let's take a look at Musk's effect. And I want you guys to cheer if you want him to win. Do you want Musk to win? Give it up for Musk!
So, that's already good. Let's see again what Kabuto has done. So, give it up for Kabuto!
No, I think we have a clear winner. I think the champ has defeated his
seems so.
Title 2 times champ in a row.
But next year. Chaos and Abductee maybe will defeat him again.
So give it up, I think our winner for this year. Give it up for Musk! Show Musk effect again!
And also give it up for Kabuto, second place in the 2015 Shader Coding Competition.
Shader Pig!
So, Musk, how are you feeling?
This is awesome. Unfortunately, the Finns didn't make it.
You were planning the Finns.
Yeah, there was a ring, but my box function didn't work.
Are you gonna make a version with Finns?
Yeah, probably, with Shader Pig.
Okay, so congratulations, you're the second time, you're the title holder, two times in a row. Give it up, people, for Musk, the winner of the Shader Show-Off.
But don't forget about Kabuto, who has done this twice. He has been here last year, he has been here this year, and a solid second place. Give it up for Kabuto!
So yes, thank you very much everybody for watching. Give it up our winners, but also give a big hand of applause to Abductee and Chaos giving us voiceover commentary from the back. Give it up for Abductee and Chaos. Thank you to our DJs, Lou Goober, Alkema, Ronnie, for playing the music. Big up for the event team for setting this up. And a very big hand for Gargai for helping out with all the stuff for this. But then again, one more, a big applause for our winner, Musk!
And for Kabuto as well.
Thank you very much. This was our very, very enticing Shader Battle 2015, and I think it was a really good show. But thank you, Musk, will you be here next year to defend your title again?
Of course. Yeah, especially if you make that belt.
Yeah, because we have to make a belt for the world champion two times in a row.
No, it will be a Shader Pig.
Or a Shader Pig.
So yeah, thank you. Shader Pig.
Thank you very much. This was the Shader competition.
And I hope we have some new participants next year. So please apply. Just contact us if you want to rock the stage with coding and not doing music.
If you feel like you can stand up to Musk, go for it.
Thank you very much. Coming up shortly, here is the job forum.
Coming up.
So if you need a job, maybe a job shader coding, stay tuned. We're going to have some companies offering jobs to you.